welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be doing a first impressions of the Steam straightener brush. I'm going to test it on my hair. Well, you can pretty much see, but I'm going to show you how I did it on my hair, and then I'm going to come back and let you know how I feel about the product. All right, so keep on watching. So to start off, I'm starting on air dried hair. So this is hair that I washed the night before and just let it air dry. I detangled it and then put some heat protectant in it. I will leave that in the description box below. So here is the first time I'm running it through my hair. I'm like, okay, it's all right. The steam is coming through. It's not heat, guys. I mean, it's not burning, it's steam. You do have to add water to the straightener in order for the steam to come through. So here, I'm just gonna go ahead and detangle my hair. So I think I'm doing a pretty good job. I think I left one knot in there that screwed me up, man. But anyways, I forgot it was not just your regular straightener, so as you can tell, I was struggling with the brush, but then I went ahead and figured it all out and I was brushing it through, and then when I got to the end, it started to, you know, I had to pull a little bit hard, but I think it's because I didn't tangle my hair properly. But throughout the process, I do find that I had to straighten the ends of my hair a couple passes because it wasn't getting as straight as I would have liked it to get. And I think that's because the ends of my hair are a little bit older, so they do require a little bit more support, we can just say that, in the most friendly way. Anyways, I did get a little bit better as I got through the process. I had to get used to holding the straightener in one direction. Usually when I straighten my hair, it doesn't matter what direction I'm going or what direction I'm holding the brush, but this one you have to be very particular because if you hold it the other way around, the water is just going to spill out all over you. So you want to make sure that you're pointing it with the arrows facing down. But you know, I really enjoyed this. I had it at 410 degrees, so it wasn't too hot. And again, I don't think it's piping hot because I didn't get my hair bone straight. And then at the end of, you know, doing one side, I just went ahead and took the ends again and straightened it just to get it, you know, slick. So here is the finished product. I'm just gonna go ahead and comb out my hair, and that's it, guys. So here is the finished look, guys. I honestly feel like my hair looks silky and smooth, and it looks like, you know, it's thicker than it usually is because I have thin hair, so I don't necessarily like bone straight hair because I just feel like, you know, it's just flat hair sitting there. I like volume to my hair, so this definitely gave me volume. I feel like I'm gonna say deuces to the straightener for now, and I'm gonna be rocking with this because, oh, it just matches me where I need it to be. I didn't even have to blow dry my hair. I went straight from air dried hair to this brush, and I think the brush really helped, you know, comb out, you know, the snags. I did have a little bit of detangling, so I had to go and brush it a little bit, but honestly, I'm loving the results. Silky smooth, some volume. That's it, man. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.